You can work outdoors all year round. This happens to be one of my favorite spots to work outdoors, the Universal Amphitheatre. They're getting it ready because tonight, well, this place is going to be filled with about a little over 5,000 people. A million little stars overhead, like tiny spotlights in the sky. I'm getting excited. Besides that, we have some fun things to show you on tape with my guest, the Starland Vocal Band, my good friend Dennis Weaver, the star of McCloud, and my special guest, Miss Joanne Woodward, who happens to be a very big movie star. And, now get this, we have with us tonight the star of one of the biggest films of all time. You saw him in Jaws, and I'm not talking about one of the people. I'm talking about the big guy himself, the shark. So stick around, folks. It's going to be a good one.
Ladies and gentlemen, John Denver.
We'll be right back. Thank you.
The John Denver Show is brought to you on behalf of 500,000 Midwestern farmers and ranchers through their cooperatives in the farmland family. America and the American farmer. We need each other. And by time.
I was going to wait till later on in the show to tell you about this, but to be honest with you, I just can't wait. I mean, I'm so excited about this that I can't believe it. You see, the thing is, there is a major motion picture being made, and I'm one of the stars. You see, it's a story about a guy who talks with God. And that's right. And the title of the movie is actually Oh God. And I don't have the title role. You have to start someplace. But it's like a boyhood fantasy that's come true. And see, I always imagine myself as being, you know, kind of a Cary Grant. Right? I mean, suave, sophisticated, debonair. Yeah. But torn by inner conflict. My problem being whether to spend the rest of my life with Audrey Hepburn or Raquel Welch. And so I solved the whole thing by just running away with Catherine Deneuve. Catherine Deneuve. And actually, you know, life has a funny way of kind of playing tricks on you. The movie isn't working out that way. I don't get to play opposite any of those ladies. My co-star in this film is George Burns. That's right, George Burns plays God, and he's great, you know, but I mean, let's face it, he's not Catherine Deneuve. But George, you see, the thing about George is he has a trademark, you know, he has that cigar. Now see, all of the great actors had their own trademark. Clark Gable had those ears, you know, Groucho had that walk, you know, and the mustache that he had painted on, and Bogey had that lisp when he talked. Well, I figure I've got it made, folks, because I've got my trademark, too. My glasses. I figure I'm probably one of the first leading men in motion pictures to wear his glasses. Actually, now that I think of it, there are two of us. Times are kind of changing, and there are actually two leading men, two incredibly attractive, cool, muscular, macho leading men who wear glasses. Myself and Woody Allen. So what I want to do now is to show you just what I can do as an actor. And we have here a story that I can really get my teeth into. It's the tragic story of San Antonio Rose. A romantic, bittersweet saga of a young American and the beautiful Mexican girl that he loves. And you see, many years ago, he left Mexico and he went to the city seeking fame, seeking fortune. And now he's returning to Mexico to seek out this beautiful woman and to ask for her hand in marriage. The beautiful, the sad, the tragic story of San Antonio Rose. Oh,
two words I know still live in my heart all alone. For the moonlit past by the Alamo, and rose my rose of San Antonio. Our rose, we rose of San Antonio.
When I first met Joanne Woodward, I fell in love with her. Unfortunately, so did Paul Newman. Why she chose him over me is one of life's great mysteries. But that's the way it goes. I tell you that the chemistry with Joanne and I, it's really something. When you see us together, sparks are going to fly, going to light up the whole area. Now, I know she's a little bit nervous about coming out with me tonight, and I wanted her to know that I'm not a sore loser about her choosing Paul. So I have her here in the show, and I don't want to keep her waiting. I want to bring her out, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Joanne Woodward. Never ask. Good evening to you.
Thank you. Chemistry,
spark, fun. That's
beautiful,
Joanne. Joanne, I've said it before. You put the two of us together, you're going to see fireworks.
Thank you.
first acting job that I had was with my good friend Dennis Weaver, the star of McCloud. I ran into Dennis the other day, and as a matter of fact, I caught up with him at work. And the thing about it, well, let me show it to you. I think it's quicker that way.
Right up there. The John Denver Show will continue in a moment.
Some people don't when it comes to fishing, you know?
Good evening, Barton.
Well, wait and watch your mind.
Oh, no, you're not.
I
thought
I had one.
Well,
boy, that's exciting.
You can have everything.
Oh, no, not again. Doggone.
What happened?
Gets tangled up. Just nothing seems to be going right for me today. I know we're going to catch one. Oh, I got a bite. There, here we go. Okay. Let's see here. Something on the water. I know that something's going to happen here any minute. I just can't wait. Watch this here.
There it goes. I'm walking there.
Mary Bell, I've got one. That's a big fish. Look at that. What? Golly.
Well, he was right about one thing. I sure I'll bite him.
All alone, I'm so all alone. La-dee-da-dee-da.
You, the Starland Vocal Band. This is Bill Danoff and Kathy Danoff. This is Margot Chapman and John Carroll. And I think they're great. What we'd like to do now is to show you, we want to do a little thing for you that we think is really neat, and it's also a little weird. But you see, it happened like this. It was just a little bit outside of town on a cold, dark night. And, ask me, there's something strange about all this. Full moon, crazy old house. Let's get out of here.
Gives me the creeps.
Now, you guys are a bunch of turkeys. Just because there's a beautiful moon out, little critters making neat noises in the bushes, you're all worried. Now, I'm going to go up and ring that doorbell, and our troubles will all be over. Now, come on, you guys. Huh? Sam. Golly, that sounds crazy. Bill, Taffy, Margot, Chuck, what has happened to you guys? You look terrible. What's happened to me? Oh. Oh, boy.
Coffee, I love tea. I love Java, Java, and it loves me. Coffee and tea and Java and me.
A cup,
a cup,
a cup,
a cup. I love Java, sweet and hot. Oops, Mr. Motor, I'm a coffee pot. Shoot me the pot, now pour me a shot.
A cup,
a cup,
a cup,
a cup,
a
cup. Slip me a slug from that wonderful mug, and I'll cut me rug till I'm snug in a jug. A sliced up onion and a raw one.
Raw one.
Baby, you look good to me tonight. Oh, now, baby, you look good to me.
crystal clear ocean, right on the crest of a wild raging storm. To work in the service of life and the living, in search of the answers to questions unknown. To be part of the movement, part of the growing, part of beginning to understand.
Germany? West Germany. Folks call me the Dutchendorf kid.
Düsseldorf kid, yeah.
The Dutchendorf.
Dutchendorf kid.
Dutchendorf.
Right, Düsseldorf. Hey, how come you got these guns on?
24 hours after I hit Denver, there won't be a bad man left on his feet.
Hey, we have got something in common.
Indians.
Them too.
No, outside.
And the tunnel along them will be in Denver. Oh, I almost forgot to tell you. The engines scalped the engineer, and the train's just running wild. Oh, I wouldn't want to be in your shoes. Well, this is where I get off.
Golly, the speed this train is going, we're going to be... Excuse me. What's everybody doing inside here? It's a beautiful day out. The birds are chirping. The sun is shining. The tumbleweeds are tumbling.
Tumbleweeds? There are six gunslingers out there tearing up our town. He's talking about tumbleweeds.
Well, old-timer, today is your lucky day.
Hooray! He's a new liquor salesman.
Nope. I'm the man you sent for 6 months ago to clean up Denver. The Dutchendorf kid. Now, excuse me, folks, but I've got work to do.
Dutch, you're a brave man. You're dumb, but you're brave. Good luck.
Know me. I'm the
Thank you. up my red stool
possible by my friends here at the Universal Studio Tours. Not only did they open up this beautiful amphitheater for us to sing in, but they also gave us the whole back lot to play around with. It's really been a lot of fun for me. And I do thank the folks here at Universal and everybody involved in the show, and I thank you for watching, my friends. Good night.
The John Denver Show has been presented to you by Timex. Timex Marlins. Attractively styled, sensibly priced. Watches that take a licking and keep on ticking. And on behalf of 500,000 Midwestern farmers and ranchers, through their cooperatives and the farmland family, America and the American farmer, we need each other. Appearing on tonight's show were Joe Baker and R.G. Brown. This is Dick Tufeld speaking. Tomorrow,
a night of fun and laughter with a terrific comedy lineup. Welcome Back, Cotter, Bonnie Miller, The Tony Randall Show, and television's funniest lady, Nancy Walker. All tomorrow, starting at 8, 7 Central and Mountain. Stay tuned now for a special, Olivia Newton-John. It's next, here on ABC.